Charlie, we're going to do this for you. We're going to do it for the Lord first, but we're going to do it for Brother Charlie. You pray for us this morning. But I do love this old song, and me and him's been through it twice, so we'll see how this goes. But you know, a lot of times we wait on God during the daytime. We expect him to show up right now. But sometimes it's in the darkest times that he shows up. Sometimes he waits until the midnight hour when things ain't going real good. That's what happened over there in a jail one time. They was locked up. Things didn't look real good. You know, it's hard to praise him when things ain't going right. You ever felt that way? It's hard to raise your hand. It's hard to worship when things just ain't going your way. But long about midnight, they began to pray and sing praises. I don't know what they sang. I don't know what they prayed. But one thing I know happened. As they touched heaven. I want you to know this morning that you can touch him if you need him. You pray for us. Well, I have journeyed through the long dark.
Down on my knees, as I feel.
in spite of the storm. Well, I have been young, but I'm older now, and there has been beauty these eyes have seen. Listen. That's where God proved His love to me. Now the anchor holds, though the ship's been battered, the sails are torn. I have fallen down on my knees as I face the raging sea. The anchor holds in spite of the storm.
I heard a preacher say one time when I was a kid, he said, there's a lot of times we need an answer.
Yeah.
You ever been to a doctor and you're looking for an answer?
Yes.
But maybe sometimes the answer that comes from the doctor isn't the answer you needed. You ever been there?
Yeah.
Have you ever went to the Lord and asked Him for an answer, but the answer that He comes back with ain't the answer that you're ready for? You ever done that? I remember one time I broke my arm on a set of monkey bars. We got to Kennestone Hospital and the doctor said, well, it's broken. But Brother Mac, it didn't fix the fact that my arm was broken. I already knew it was broken. Arm was hurting pretty bad. I scared.
Bless you, Josh.
Answer hadn't helped me a bit, Brother Brandon. But then the doctor called a nurse in, and they wheeled a table in. They had everything in there that would scare a little boy to death. But they gathered my arm up. They laid it on a table, and they began to put a cast on. You say, what's the cast, preacher? That was the anchor that held my arm together.
Yeah.
And in the days ahead, the anchor fixed what the answer could not. What the doctor told me was wrong didn't fix anything. I was still in pain. My arm was still broke. And if all I'd have done was had an answer, I'd have never had an arm that was healed.
Right.
And sometimes we look for an answer.
Yes. Amen.
But we don't need to look for the answer. We need to look to the anchor.
Right.
Because Brother Bill, no matter what's going on,
bless you, Lord,
the answer ain't going to fix the problem. But when the anchor shows up, He can pull it all together, yeah. Brother Bob.
Yeah.
I'm reminded of those disciples that were in that storm.
Yeah.
The storm was raging, but all of a sudden, there came an anchor. The answer was walking to them. But when the anchor stepped up in the boat and He said, peace, be still. You don't always need an answer. But friends, you better know the anchor today. You better know the anchor. And can I tell you the first time the anchor was ever seen? Yeah, He was seen at a manger. Yeah, He was seen in a trial. Yeah, He was seen on Calvary. Those things were all prophesied. When He stood at a tomb, risen victorious over death, hell, and the grave. There the anchor was, standing before all of mankind. And the anchor said, I'm here. And I'm reminded in John 14, Brother Brandon, he gave another answer. And the anchor said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again. And I will receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And I just got a sneaky suspicion that somebody in here today is looking for an answer.
Come on now.
But you ain't never going to get the answer you need until you meet the anchor.
Yes.
Do you know the anchor this morning? Is it all right to get out of the normal routines of church? I don't know. I'm about sick of normal routine. I'm about sick of normal routine. This old world has got enough to drive you crazy every day. And I don't need the routine. There's days as the call of pastor and call to preach, that don't fix the problem, Miss Regina. A church full of people don't fix the problem, but I'm glad the anchor does. And I just wonder this morning, I'm looking at a bunch of people that are fighting back tears and fighting back problems, and you're facing hell by the half acre and you're probably camped out on the back 40. I wouldn't care what nobody thought. Well, preacher, if I go to the altar and tell the Lord that I need the anchor, they may laugh at me. Well, I wouldn't care. I wouldn't care what they thought. Listen here, you need to know the anchor.
Amen.
Hell's right around the corner. Problems are right around the corner. But the anchor is still there.
Yes.
Read you one other verse of scripture that made me think. The Hebrew writer said this, that by two immutable things in which it was impossible for God to lie. I don't know what you're looking for God to tell you today, but I promise you this, it's impossible for Him to lie. He said it's impossible for Him to lie that we might have a strong consolation. Who have fled for refuge to lay hold upon the hope that is set before us. The word hope means the expectation of greater good. That's what we expect, is something better than what we're going through right now. But listen to verse number 19. The writer said, which hope we have as an anchor. An anchor for the soul. They can fix a lot of things in my mind and in my body, Brother Brian. But the best thing that man has to offer cannot fix my soul. But Brother Bob, there is an anchor, amen, that can solve my hurting and lonely soul. And I promise you this, it's both sure and it's both steadfast. There ain't no Democrat going to fix it. There ain't no Republican going to fix it. There ain't no bank account going to fix it. I'm telling you, some people are moving that need to meet the anchor. I'm telling you, things are not going to fix it, friend. But the anchor that's sure and steadfast, that will go with you all the way to the end, that is what matters. Do you know the anchor this morning? Have you ever met Him? Don't sit here and act like you ain't got nothing going on. Everybody's got something going on. What problem do you face? If you're facing a problem, don't look for an answer. Go to the anchor and say, Lord, just help me find peace in the middle of the storm. We find in the storm stories, they never got out of the body of water they were in. The storm just stopped. Every bit of the elements were around them, but the anchor came and solved the problem. Do you know the anchor? Do you know the anchor? More than anything you could ever do in your life, you better know the anchor. When answers won't work, the anchor will. Brother Brandon, will you sing that last verse again?
I've had visions, and I've had dreams, and I've even held them in my hand.
Amen.
But I never knew they would slip right just like they were only grains of sand. But the anchor holds, though the ship is battered, anchor holds in spite of the storm. I have fallen down on my knees as I face the raging sea. In spite of the storm.